te bata, saca, 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 sem nem se preocupar.
My personal advice is to take on projects and events that you think are way beyond your skill level, because this forces you to do research beforehand on all of the things that you're not too sure about, and this can improve your skills really, really fast. At least it has for me in the past year. Plus, live painting is really fun. It helps increase your confidence, your speed, and people are really complimentary during this process and will come up to you and ask questions and even sometimes commission you, so I definitely suggest it.
So let me teach you guys about an amazing drawing method known as automatic drawing. Automatic drawing is basically the practice of letting go and changing your mind state that allows you to flow on the paper and open up your imagination. It's actually quite simple. Take out a piece of paper and any drawing utensil and just start with no idea in your head of what you're about to draw. Just keep drawing and don't stop until the paper's filled. It doesn't matter what you draw, just focus on the flow and relax your mind. This is a practice that all great artists such as Mobius, Jack Kirby, and many others have been known to do, as it helps prevent burnout and refreshes the mind. When I do this, I feel like a kid again, creating without a care in the world. In the end, your drawing doesn't have to look like anything at all. Just enjoy the process of creation in its purest form.
Here are the best art hacks for lazy artists. Instead of having to clean your paint palette like every 5 seconds, you're gonna get some saran wrap, cut a little bit, and mold it to your paint palette. Use it like normal, and when you're done, all you do is peel it off, throw it away, and it's completely clean. Instead of using a regular watercolor brush and having to constantly dip it, I'm gonna have you use a water brush. It activates the water on its own, and cleaning this thing is so easy. If you have one eye that's beautiful and perfect, and the other one is absolute trash, scribble on a piece of paper, turn it around, and trace the eyeball you like. Scribble over the newly traced eyeball, flip it over, retrace it, and just like that, you have another symmetrical eyeball. Happy drawing and follow from.
Most groundbreaking art advice I ever got was to paint with my eyes instead of my brain, and I'll try to show you what that means.
The whites of your eyes aren't white, they're actually blue, gray.
Blonde hair is not yellow, it's all kinds of brown, green, white, sepia.
And skin tone isn't just white or tan, it's a blend of pinks, browns, black.
And unfortunately your teeth aren't white either, it's a tan, bone colored stuff.
What do you say?
mistakes. Draw on all the shoes like long slippers. Everything is not a flip-flop, you know what I'm saying? And we don't have flat duck feet, okay? No. Think of the bottom like two planes, and then the top is diagonal. Number two, not allowing the clothes to flow. And by that, I mean sometimes we draw the body and the clothes on the body and just automatically mold the clothes to the body, but you can actually draw a diagonal line in some spots. It looks so natural. Number three, only drawing the top of baseball caps like this. And I know the angle matters, but check out how easy this is. Little curve, little hump. And then that inside part with the line that connects with the face, that's important. Number four, avoiding voluminous ruffles in dresses. Okay, so watch closely. Swoopy, swoopy, line, 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 tiny line, tiny line, tiny line. And there you go. You have unlocked a world. Number five, avoiding drawing the sides of the torso. So think about the torso like a three-dimensional box, okay? And if you draw the side of that box, your arm is going to connect right here. And when that happens, the tank sleeve is going to curve around that arm. Hope these helped, and happy drawing, guys. Here's a hack for drawing those pesky anime mouths. Ta-da! JK. First of all, you're going to draw a straight line across the jaw area. Then you're going to measure down from the corner of one eye and draw a C shape. Then down from the corner of the other eye, draw a backwards C shape so they look like little bitty pitchforks. Then you're going to take your eraser and erase that center line. Connect to the bottom of those two lines and then come up and almost connect the top, but not quite. Then draw a diagonal line connecting the top of that oval shape to the corner of your line. And then the same thing on the bottom. So make sure to shade those in nice and good, and if you want, draw a little lower lip curve on the bottom, and there you have it.
Do you throw away your kneaded erasers when they get too dirty and hard to use? Here's why you shouldn't. I talked in a previous video about how they're a great blending tool, but did you know that you can also clean them? Here's how. All you need is some soap and warm water. Put a little soap into the palm of your hand and rub the eraser in it. Kneaded erasers are made from an unvulcanized rubber and are able to absorb and flatten any substance. Rinse it thoroughly in some warm water and then knead it to remove the water. If it starts to feel too pulpy, you can blot it on a washcloth to remove some excess water. Depending on how dirty your eraser is, you may need to repeat this process a few more times. When you're satisfied with how clean it is, you'll want to knead it for a while until all the water is removed. You can have fun with this. Here's my newly cleaned eraser next to a new one, and here it is next to a dirty one. And finally, here it is in action. Good as new.
Egg tempera is a permanent paint medium made from dry pigments and egg yolk, and we're going to show you how you can make it at home. Crack an egg and separate the yolk and the egg white. Transfer the yolk onto a paper towel and roll it around a bit to absorb the rest of the egg white. Puncture the egg yolk and release the inner yolk, leaving the outer membrane and pouring it into a container. Add a few drops of water to thin it out. Using a well palette, palette knife, and pipette, section off as much pigment as you want into each well. Add several drops of egg yolk and water to thin it out as desired. Mix it with your palette knife. Egg tempera uses water as a thinner, but make sure you don't add too much as the paint will lose its strength. You can add a few drops of rubbing alcohol if the pigment doesn't disperse properly into the yolk binder. Using a rigid support and a chalk gesso ground, lay down your first marks. Egg tempera is a very delicate and translucent medium that dries instantly as you apply it to the surface. Its beauty lies in its ability to capture detail, precision, and depth like no other paint medium.
So it's time to talk about the biggest mystery for artists, which is, what are those canvas wedges for? Most artists just toss them in a drawer or throw them out, but they can actually be pretty useful to tighten the tension of your canvas. When you put them in, you expand the wooden frame by just a millimeter or so, just enough to tighten the surface tension of the canvas. As a heavier-handed painter, I tend to put them in after I finish the painting, but you can put them in before you start or keep them aside, because most canvases become loose over time. And the wedges mean you can tighten the canvas without restretching it. Just don't take them out once they're...
So I never knew that painting the edges of your canvas is something that art professors hate. I started doing this when I decided I wanted to paint on larger canvases. And personally, I just feel like paintings this big do not need frames. And leaving that edge exposed just looks really weird, especially when it's hanging on the wall. I've always continued by painting on the edges. Aesthetically, of course, I think it looks great, but I think it also gives more opportunity to be creative and literally think outside the box. Like, I'm really obsessed with how this painting turned out.
When you're drawing human figures, you should be thinking about gravity. Because even if it's invisible, we interact with it every day. A lot of the time when we draw figures, they wind up looking something like this. We know something is wrong, but we can't tell exactly what. The truth is, even though gravity pulls us down in a straight line, a pencil straight human body is actually less stable in balance than a more realistic human form. The human body is built to run, jump, squat, whatever. Consequently, our body is built more like a spring than a pencil. Because our body is made of curves, we buckle under gravity. And because we buckle, energy moves throughout our body more like a river than a waterfall. That's why a lot of bones in our body that appear perfectly straight actually have a slight bend to them. And if they don't, they're usually not perfectly perpendicular to the ground. Lines that appear perfectly straight are usually an illusion built by the summation of curves. You could draw 90% of your figure with curved lines instead of straight ones, and it could still appear perfectly balanced. So if your drawings are coming out looking a little stiff, try thinking about your figure's weight and incorporate more curved lines than straight ones.
How to fix damaged paint brushes. Take some honey, mix it in like such, and then pop it in the oven for about 20 seconds. Now be careful because it'll be hot once you grab it out. Rinse with water, and then you're good to go. Hit that follow button.